Hi, my name is Dr. John Shim, and I want to discuss cervical foraminotomy. By now, you have already tried non-surgical treatments and have decided to move forward with surgery. Cervical foraminotomy surgery is offered because your pain pattern and physical examination matches the findings on your diagnostic studies. Foraminotomy means enlarging the space for the exiting nerve. Let me show you a typical cervical MRI with narrowing of the space for the nerve. This is the sagittal view. It's a side view of your neck. For most patients, there are some normal disc levels, but the offending narrowing will be identified near the space or foramen where the nerves exit from the spinal cord. The narrowing is usually caused by a combination of bone spurring and/or disc herniation. The axial view, or the cross-sectional view, will provide another angle to visualize the encroachment on the nerve. Depending on the location of the bone spur or disc herniation, sometimes a cervical foraminotomy approach may require too much spinal cord manipulation. In that scenario, another surgical approach may have much less risks. For the surgeon, there are many nuances that need to be considered. Experience helps when planning the operation. Still, the exposure is relatively the same. For the average size patient, a less than 1.5 inch incision is made over the intended surgical site. Care is taken to preserve the large neck ligaments called the ligamentum nuchi. Muscle tissues are retracted away from the bony and ligament covering over the spinal canal. Magnification is used to obtain better visualization of the anatomy. Tools such as burrs, Kerrs and rongeurs, and microcurettes are used to remove the bony covering. The narrowing is opened, the foramen is then opened to remove pressure off the nerve. Bone spurs are shaved, and if needed, disc material is gently removed and taken away from the nerve and spinal cord. The wounds are then closed. Most patients now have the procedure performed on an outpatient basis. Greater than 90% of the properly selected patients have improvement of their symptoms. Most will return back to all their activities within a few months. This is Dr. John Shim, and I hope this video helped you understand the cervical foraminotomy surgery. Thank you.